Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to the Successfully Unemployed Show. My name is Dustin Heiner, and I am super excited to have you here with me. And I help people to never have to work a job again by investing in businesses, by creating side hustles, by investing in real estate, and basically becoming successfully unemployed. And that's what I want to see for you. Now, today, we're going to be talking about the work-life balance, because as we're building businesses, as we're investing, as we're doing side hustles, we want to make sure that we're not burning the candle at both ends. And I want to show you how that plays out in your life. Now today, let's jump in the show where we're going to be talking all about the work-life balance and the P/PC balance in our life. Now, a lot of people may be thinking, well, what in the world is the P/PC balance in our life? And how does that help me to become successfully unemployed? Now, in this show, we're going to be interviewing so many people, but at the same time, I'm going to be also showing you how and what it takes to become successfully unemployed, because that's what I want for you. I want you to never have to work a job again. See, I quit my job when I was investing in real estate. I was literally working a job. I was working a job, a technology job for the county government in California, and eventually I got laid off. But from that, I realized I need to become successfully unemployed. I need to be financially independent. And I started investing into real estate. But at the same time, I was also having other businesses. I was working my job. And it came about that I was actually burning the candles at both ends. And what that actually means is I was getting worn out. I was getting worn down. I was getting so tired. And I literally did not have any capacity to do anymore because I was doing so many things. Now, in today's show, I want to talk to you about having a good P/PC balance, which is basically a couple things. The P in the P/PC balance is the production. The production, what you can produce in your life. When I was getting so tired, burning the candle at both ends, working so much, working a full-time job, having three different businesses, at the same time investing in real estate, I was doing so many things. I was doing. I was focusing on production. Now, the PC part is the production capability. So you have the P, which is production. You also have the PC, which is the production capability. And now, before I get into what the P/PC balance is and what that actually comes from, is the great book by Steven Covey called The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. Love that book. I read that before I became successful and employed, implemented into my life, and changed my life. Now, I want to give you a story. It's a fable. Many of you have already heard this fable because you've heard it when you were a little kid. I know I heard it when I was a little kid, but I didn't know how it actually applied to me. It's the story or the fable of the goose that laid the golden egg. Now, the goose that laid the golden egg basically comes down to there's a farmer. He's a farmer. He has a bunch of animals, and one goose in particular one day starts producing golden eggs, like solid golden eggs. Well, at first he picks up the golden egg and says, you know what? It's probably a fake. And he's about ready to throw it away, but he realizes it might be a good idea just to get it appraised. In case it's actually a golden egg, I might have something on my hands. He takes it, gets it appraised, and it turns out it is a solid golden egg. But what happens the next day? The next day, the goose lays another golden egg. And the day after that, the goose lays another golden egg. So the goose keeps laying golden eggs. Now, what happens is, eventually over time, the farmer is spending the golden egg, you know, selling and spending the golden egg and just taking that gold and spending it and getting everything he wants. And then one time, he gets really impatient. He gets impatient to where he thinks, you know what? All these eggs are coming out of this goose. What if I just get all the eggs out now? So what the farmer does, he decides to cut open that goose, to kill the goose, to open the goose up, to try to get all the eggs out, when he realizes that the goose was making the golden eggs every single day. It's not just magically hidden inside, so you can't just reach in there and grab them. Well, we look at that now, he doesn't have any golden eggs and he has no longer ability to produce that golden egg. That goose is gone. So now he has neither. That is what we talk about, the P/PC balance in our life. If we're working too hard or we're not getting enough education and growing ourselves. And that's both of those. If we do too much in one direction, that can actually be very detrimental to us. Now, the P in the P/PC, the P is production. What are you actually producing? Are you producing the golden eggs? Not necessarily, you know, making sure that you're producing golden eggs. Not that. It's just what you can produce. It could be producing a book. It could be producing something for your job or producing whatever. It's your production. Now, the PC is the production capability. Now, the production capability is basically the goose, and the production is the egg, is what it's actually put out, is the production. Now, what Stephen Covey helps us to understand is the P/PC balance is where we're not too heavy on production and we're not too heavy on production capability. Now, what that looks like in life and in business is you're so focused on production, like getting the money, but you overlook or you don't pay attention to how you make money and how to make a better business to make money. Let me give you an example. So in life, let's say you had a lawnmower. You're using that lawnmower. It's doing a great job. It's cutting grass. Brand new out of the box. It's cutting grass very, very well. But, you know, that's the product. Now is the cutting grass. But the PC, the production capability, is you're not maintaining that lawnmower. You're not sharpening the blades. You're not changing the oil. You're not changing the spark plugs. You're not cleaning it off. You're not doing things to maintain that thing that is producing what you want, which is a cut grass, a cut lawn. You're not producing, or you're not taking care of that. That production capability then is declines because you're so heavy on the production and nothing on production capability. Now that is bad because you're too far on one side. Same thing. If you're too far on the production capability, if you are literally wiping down, polishing that lawnmower over and over again, constantly sharpening the blades, changing the spark plugs, changing the oil, but literally never cutting the grass, what it's intended to do, you're too focused on production capability as opposed to the production. So you're doing so much and not getting anything done. Nothing's to show for that. Same thing like in life. If you're going to school and you know that you need to actually pass and you get a good grade for whatever it is, whatever class you're taking, if you're just studying, and you take so much time to actually study, but you never actually go and take the test. If you never take the test, what's the use of doing all that studying? Because in the end, that production capability isn't producing anything with that grade and that test. So in the end, you're too heavily on production capability. But then again, if you're too focused on taking the test, you don't study, you don't do anything to prepare for that test, you're only worried about that test and just thinking about that test, then you're too heavily on the production side. Same thing. If you have this in your relationship, in your life, if you're too focused on, let's say you're married and you have your spouse. Let's say you're too focused on taking care of the kids, getting them to their next, soccer game or going to work, or you're taking care of everything in the business, all the things that are produced in the marriage, having a nice house, having food on the table. Well, these are all great things. But if you solely focus on that and you do not focus on the marriage, building the marriage up, if you don't focus on communication, going on date nights and making your relationship better, eventually all you will have is the house. All you'll have is that entertainment system or whatever it might be because that's all you've put into. You didn't build and enrich the relationship. Now, the opposite would be also true where if you only look in your spouse's eyes or your girlfriend or boyfriend's eyes, like whoever you're dating, if all you ever do is just look in their eyes longingly and just say, oh, I love you, or this, that, and the other, where all you do is you're so consumed with that person, but you don't go out and make money. You don't manage your car. You don't do things that you need to do to survive. You don't make sure you have your roofs covered, or you aren't getting any leaks. You're not taking care of your property. You're not doing anything else other than looking in your boyfriend, girlfriend, or whoever's eyes. You're only focusing on the production capability as opposed to something that's being produced. So what I want you to do as you're thinking about becoming successfully unemployed is be understanding of the P/PC balance, where you don't want to be too heavily focused on production. You don't want to be too heavily focused on production capability. And another analogy I want to give you is imagine you have an axe And your job is to cut down five trees. And it's going to take you all day to cut down five trees. And you're solely focused on getting those trees cut down. Like, that's your product. Your product is that tree fell and on the ground. And so you get that axe, brand new axe, you start swinging away. Well, the first tree goes down pretty quick because you have a nice, sharp, awesome axe. You keep knocking it, knocking it. Boom, number two comes down. But number three, you start hacking at number three and it's taking you forever. It's like, man, it's like I'm hitting this with a baseball bat. Nothing's coming out. And you keep going and keep going. By the end of the day, you maybe have that third one down. You have the fourth and fifth one still left because you are so focused on the production, getting that tree on the ground, you didn't focus on the production capability, which is sharpening that store, that axe. Because after you hit a couple times, it starts to get dull. The more times you hit it, it gets even more dull. If you don't stop to sharpen that axe, to improve yourself, whatever you're doing, that production will eventually decrease. Right now it's high. When you first start, it'll keep getting lower and lower unless you sharpen that axe. And so what you want to do is you, as best you can, that tree comes down really great. Even if you don't need to sharpen it, you stop to sharpen it because you know eventually, like the next two or three swings, it's going to start getting dull and you want to fix that. You start sharpening that blade, and then that next tree comes down really fast, and then it starts getting a little more dull. You sharpen that blade. You take the extra 20 minutes to really sharpen that axe really good, and then you start swinging. Same thing with you in anything and everything that you do. You want to make yourself better, but then you also want to produce. Now, looking at real estate, because I love teaching and showing people about real estate investing. Imagine somebody saying, you know what? I'm going to skip the learning phase on the real estate. I got this down. I just know I buy a house. I put a renter in it. Good. I'm done. They completely skip over the education. They don't get a coach. They don't read books. They don't listen to podcasts. They don't do anything like that. They immediately go out and buy a property. Well, I'm going to say that I almost guarantee, I'll give you like a 99% probability, you'll lose money if you do it that way. You're solely focused not on the PC, the production capability, getting better, getting knowledge and getting education and training. You're solely focused on getting that one property. That production is the one thing that you want. So you go after that production. You buy that property. Well, in the end, because you did not have the production capability, you bought a bad property. You bought a money pit. You bought one that nobody wants to rent. Even property managers don't want to manage it. On the flip side, and this happens to a lot of people that I coach investing in real estate. What they do is they solely focus on the learning aspect. They want to continually learn and they 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 learn, but they don't actually pull the trigger and buy that first property. So you don't want to be too heavily production focused and get that property before you learn anything. And you don't want to be too production capability focused where you're constantly learning and you're learning, but you never get the job done by buying that first property. You want to put them both together where you're getting better, learning, getting education, getting coaching. At the same time, you're going to get that production going. So you're doing both. So what I want for you, as you're becoming successfully employed, whatever it is that you're doing, maybe it's a side job, maybe it is a side hustle, maybe you're a freelance writer, whatever it might be, I want you to also be thinking about the production capability. You don't want to be solely focused on production, like the making money. You also want to focus on enriching yourself, making yourself better. Because I'll tell you, for me, if I write for more than like 2 hours, if I just keep writing for 2 hours, after that, my production cap, like when I first, you know, the first 30 minutes is really, really high. And then after that, it gets a little lower and then a little lower. But about 2 hours, it's literally down here. So what I was producing at like 100, and when I first started, by the time that 2 hours is up, I'm at like a 10. And so I need to refresh. I stop. I go hang out with my family. I'm blessed to be successfully unemployed, so I don't have to work. And so I go and hang out with my family. We go get some lunch. I just basically get my brain out of it. That's helping me to have the production capability, get out and get recharged. And then I come back about an hour later. And then my production's back up to where I'm actually producing where I should be. And so I want you to be thinking about that. Keep thinking that in the back of your mind as you're going through the day, working your job, because you got to be working your job to provide for your family, to take care of your necessities, while you're building your businesses, while you're investing in real estate, while you're moving forward in your life to literally be successfully employed and never work a job again. Now, see, what I do is I teach people how to invest in real estate rental properties, and I show them What you can do is you can literally buy a property, make $250 or more every single month in passive income, and then literally scale that up, do it over and over again. But if you do it the wrong way, by just focusing on the $250, you're gonna do it wrong because you're not learning how to build the business first, how to do everything right. So I wanna say you guys are fantastic. I really appreciate you here. Now in the Successful Unemployed Show, you're gonna learn so much from other people. See, I quit my job. I was successfully employed. I retired at 37 years old with real estate, investing in rental properties. I'm gonna bring on so many business owners, side hustle people, investors, all this sort of stuff to show you how they did it. They're just normal people just like us. We're normal people and we want to show you how you can be successfully unemployed too. So you guys are fantastic. Thank you so much for being here with me. I really appreciate your time. You take care. I'll see you next time.